Thank you, Madam Chairman. Real quick, and then I'm going to yield. Mr. Gordon, you said that if you take your put together a business plan and take it to a bank, there's nobody there that's qualified to look at it.
It's just
if
we there are people there, but what Congress needs to understand is we are in a crisis. We haven't had business loans and liquidity for 3 years. This isn't like a future problem that we're talking about. We're talking about how to solve this problem right now. There's businesses going out of business right now.
If you put the federal government in charge of direct lending, do you think there's going to be anybody in the federal government qualified to look at a business plan and make a decision? Just yes or no.
Okay. There, every single SBA office I go into, there are extremely qualified people there. Some of the smartest people around work for the SBA.
Yeah, I'm going to yield to Mr.
And they're really, really qualified.
Thank you, Mr. Graves. Quick question. I've got a number of questions here. Mr. Smith, you've made some great points, and as a former bank regulator, you're right on. I'm telling you, you're right on is what's happening right now in our economy with the banking industry and lending, lending dollars. And with your experience with your manufacturing group, have you seen a tightening of credit to everybody across the board, or is it just the good actors, bad actors? What's your
Absolutely, experience? It's across the board.
Okay. You know, Ms. Dorfman, I've heard you testify a couple times in different committees, and you keep talking about direct lending. I know Mr. Graves made the comment a minute ago as well. As a regulator, and yes, I'm old enough to remember the mid-70s when I was a regulator, FHA was in the business of direct lending to farmers. That experience was a disaster, an absolute disaster for agriculture. We wound up getting people in business that had no business being in business, at least agricultural business, and wound up causing inflation in our real estate prices of our farmland, overproduction. And once we got them out of that and got the government back to guaranteeing loans instead of direct lending, we solved a lot of our problems. What data, what information do you have to believe that SBA can be a better direct lender than banks?
What we're looking for is making sure that the small businesses are accessing the capital they need. Currently, the banks are not lending. The SBA with the direct lending, and there was a question about are they qualified. Yes, they're qualified to oversee the process. There are numbers of employees that have been let go from banks that used to do the lending that could be hired into a program to provide this program.
But one of the problems that you have with direct lending, though, is Who's at risk? It's not the SBA, it's the American taxpayer. When the banks are on the hook, it's their stockholders. It's the bank itself that's on the hook, and that's a really big difference because suddenly when you've got the government involved and the people lending the money, they don't care. All you can do is qualify for the loan. If you qualify, you get the money. It's not about whether this is a viable entity that's going to be able to survive down the road and make a good customer and be able to be a good part of the community. If you qualify, you get the money. That's exactly the way it worked back in with the FHA program, and that's exactly what will happen with SBA. I have a real problem with this direct lending. I don't see how you can make it work and make it viable for what we need with regards to small bending, small businesses.
Well, and I would say with the concerns that were talked about the banks being overregulated, it's another answer to removing those regulations from the banks. The banks don't have to be involved. We're putting a program together that would make sure that we followed the 5 C's of credit, made sure that the businesses were just as viable as if they were at a bank. I think it can be done.
Would the gentleman yield?
Sure.
Let me remind the gentleman that we passed direct lending in the House. It was voted by 389. You, sir, voted for it. It's a temporary fix where it treats this economic crisis as a disaster, and it will be a temporary fix. It will not compete with the private market. It will make the loans like the SBA has done every time there is natural disaster in this country. SBA make all the loans, homeowners and small businesses. This will be a temporary fix. 6 months of performing loans will be again sold in the private market. So it is a temporary fix. Once the recession we get out, when unemployment rate goes down, it will cease. The program will cease. And let me remind the gentleman again that you voted for it.
Madam Chairman, if I could.
Thank you for yielding.
Thank you. thank you for your comments, but I think that my comments are apropos as well. It's a temporary fix. It's not a solution to the problem. And Ms. Dorfman, in my mind, is talking about a permanent fix from her previous testimony, many of the other committees at hearings that I've heard her. And I want to make a point that it is a temporary fix, as long as it doesn't, but there are problems with that temporary fix, and we've got to be very cognizant of those problems. And I'm trying to point those out this morning, that we've got to be careful that this is not a road we're going to go down. But you hit point on something there as well, Mr. Dorfman, about regulation. And Mr. Smith made the point here that one of the problems that we have with the banking institutions right now is the regulators. He's got the exact words. They've got their boot on their neck, and you have to remember that most banks are small businesses as well. They have to make a profit. They have to make things work. I'm very concerned, and I appreciate the comments of Mr. Smith. Thank you, Madam Chairman.
Mr. Minnick.
I must say I agree totally.